Question on Quora. What was your number one biggest challenge regarding fat loss? The number one most challenging, difficult challenge when it comes to fat loss for me, I've been a trainer for 15 years, is for my own personal fitness, is not diet, it's attitude. It really is. It's, you know, there's this cliche saying, attitude is everything. It really is attitude. Attitude and goals. I mean, it's really that simple. I mean, that's most of it. It's about 99% of it. But I know that people need more of an answer to actually take action on it. And that's what I want from you. I want you to take action on this video. But the number one single challenge is attitude. And you have to change your attitude. You have to change the way you view the world. You know, a lot of time, what's interesting for a lot of people, what I've noticed is that until you've gone through some sort of traumatic experience, you know, whether it's like physically tragically, like a physical tragedy, like someone dies, or maybe you break an arm, amputate an arm, something like that, or you lose a loved one, or something that's just absolutely just mind-boggling, right? People don't change. They take everything for granted. In this world, we are so pampered. We have everything for ourselves. You know, so it's kind of like you get a wake-up call, you have a loved one dies, and you go, shit, I need to take care of myself, you know? And then it changes your attitude, changes your frame of view, you know? Like, one of the things that happens to a lot of people in high school is when they get to senior year, right, attitude changes. There's this thing that happens where it's like, oh, shit, I'm not a kid anymore, you know? I'm growing up, I'm going to have to get a job, or I'm going to have to go to college, or I'm going to be different, things are going to be different. So there's attitude shift based on age, based on circumstance, based on experience. And if my biggest number one was always attitude. So, and the only way you're going to be able to change your attitude is if you have a goal that's important. You know, goals, sure, we set goals, but they got to be important. They got to be, it's the why that matters more than the how. You know, I've trained people, lots of people, lose lots of weight, change lots of lives, get people in great shape. Some people don't do so well with their fitness. You know, with losing weight. Everyone is a little bit different when it comes to this. But I remember helping this group of friends that they lost collectively, like, I want to say, like, one guy lost 100 pounds in, like, 4 months. You know, and I did very little coaching. You know, all they did was they bet. It was a betting pool. It was a big betting pool. And because of it, everyone was like, oh, shit, I'm going to, you know, I don't want to lose this money. But at the same time, they had this other thing. So they had this thing, this fear of losing this 100 bucks. They also had this immense pleasure or reward of winning 100 bucks. So they had two things. One thing basically chasing them, or the loss, and something that they had to chase, which was the gain. So a lot of the time, that immediately changes your attitude. People change your attitude. Betting changes your attitude. Putting you in circumstances where you are having to force to change, adjust your brain, changes your attitude. So that's my number one thing. So change your attitude. That's my biggest thing. Having a better attitude about losing weight, losing body fat.